Scottish Mudlarking with Nicole and Craig. Today we're going to do a bit of crafting and we're going to answer a question that has come up time and time and time again in comments. The question is, what is this? So Nicole's going to do a bit of crafting later and show you exactly how to use that. Huge thanks to everyone for watching the videos, commenting, liking and subscribing. You might have noticed we now have a little icon down in the bottom left corner, so if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on that and you'll subscribe to the channel. So please do subscribe. Keep watching to the end of the video. We have a few announcements about what's going to be coming up over the next few months. But before we get on to that, I'm going to hand over to Nicole and she's going to show you what this is and how you can use it.
So every time we've done one of our craft videos, I've used this tool and we've always got questions. What is it and how to use it? So we thought, we'll make a video and we'll show you what it is. Now this is called a jump ring opener. Now before I had this jump ring opener, I'm just going to show you what I did to open jump rings. And it's really tricky and trust me, it doesn't do your fingernails any good. So I tried opening the jump rings with my fingers and that was really painful. So I thought, I'll try it with pliers. Now I tried with pliers and that was really fiddly trying to pick up the jump rings and they just didn't work. So I went online and I found this. Now I'm going to show you how I use this jump ring opener. We're going to make a charm bracelet with the pieces of sea glass that we found in Pittenweem, and if you haven't watched the video, go check it out. Now I always put the jump ring opener on my thumb, but whatever you feel comfortable putting it on, any finger, that's entirely up to you. I'm going to put a bail on these pre-drilled sea glass pieces and then I'm going to show you how to use the jump ring opener. Now as you can see, I've pre-drilled the sea glass and we're just attaching these little sterling silver bails, and it's just a case of closing it with your pliers. And now we're going to pick up the jump ring and the pliers, and all you need to do is you need to hold the jump ring tight in the pliers and you need to put in one of the slots and you just twist it open. Now you can take the bracelet, see where you want the pendant. I'm going to start with the middle one and now I can take this little tiny piece of blue with a bail on it, and I've inserted the jump ring in one of the links of the bracelet. Now we can put the bail inside the jump ring. Now what we need to do is we need to close the jump ring properly. That means going back into the jump ring opener, inserting it here, and then twist it close. You want to make sure that the ends are aligned properly and that the jump ring is closed. And there you go. That's it attached. Okay, so now I'm going to do the same thing with the rest of the sea glass. So that's that charm bracelet with the pieces of sea glass from Pittenweem finished, and it looks really lovely. So that's a jump ring opener. If there's any other tools that you've seen us use and you want them explained, just let us know in the comments. If you're looking to get a hold of one of these jump ring openers, there's a link in the description. We found some really lovely pieces of sea glass the other day in Pittenweem and I've made them into pendants. So let's have a look at them.
So, this is where the magic happens and all the videos get edited.
Yeah, this is where you find me on a sort of like kind of Saturday, Sunday, Monday as well, usually. So as promised then, we're going to take a wee minute just to let you know what's coming up in the next few months. And just before we do that, we want to say an extra big special thanks to everybody who's helped us on Kofi. Everybody who's donated have helped us get some of the things that you can see behind me. So you'll have seen if you've visited the Kofi page that Nicole's been setting a series of goals. And I think her first goal was possibly this. So this was one of the first things then that we got through Kofi to help us make our films. The reason that we needed this is because the camera can get sort of chucked about a bit in the car, just makes it easier to transport. This is a really nice kind of solid, well padded case, just perfect for the camera that we use. So huge thank you then. The camera case was an essential item. So next up, we have this fantastic monitor. It really is, it's a beautiful monitor. It's so bright, it's really nice. It makes editing the film so much easier, so much kinder on my eyes. Our old monitor here, we've had for, how many years have we had
12?
That? 12 years, we've had that 12 years. My wonderful in-laws bought this, but you wonderful people bought this. And it is so much nicer, but we just can't tell my in-laws. This is so much nicer than that one. We hope at some point, this one's actually quite warm. I'm getting heat from this one. This one's cool and lovely. We hope at some point to get another one of these to replace this because it is just so much better quality. So for the monitor, thank you so much. That's a fantastic thing. It really makes editing these videos so much easier and so much more pleasurable. Additionally, we needed somewhere to store all these big files that our camera creates, and so we asked you for an external hard drive, and we got this fantastic, I think this is 2 terabytes, so this is a 2 terabyte Toshiba hard drive. It's brilliant. We're nowhere near filling this yet. We're going to have this for quite some time yet. We're a long way away from needing another one. It frees up space on the computer, makes the computer work a lot faster. So, essential item. Thank you so much. We need storage for the camera as well. So we asked you if we could have some storage. And we got these lovely little memory cards. Fantastic. These, again, essential items. These are all essential items to what we're going to do. And we really need them. And you have made it possible for us to have them. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Batteries. We need batteries. Between the two and having extra ones, we can film for an entire day without having to worry. So thank you. We also have chargers and... We have a little case here for the light that we can't show you because it's what's illuminating my face as I speak to you just now. But we have a box full of chargers here. Now, essential. Thank you so much. We have light. We can film inside. Sitting on top of the camera just now, there's a microphone with a really nice fluffy muffler. I'll take a photograph of that and show you what it looks like. But thank you so much for that. It's not a flash fancy item, but it's absolutely essential and it makes a huge difference to the quality of our films. Thank you so much. The very last thing I want to say thank you for is the very software itself. I was using a version of this program that was made in 2011. So a 10-year-old piece of software I've been using up until today, when I finally had a little bit of time during the making of this film, to download and install Adobe 2021. And that's what you see there. And this is where I'll be editing all our films from this point forward. Thank you so much for all this stuff that makes... It just makes this so much more possible. I just wanted to say a big... Huge thank you to Juliet, to Lynn, to Phyllis, Rowan, Ilona, Henrietta, Laura, Robin, Dina, Karen, Alexandria, Sissy, and Harold. You're stars, absolute stars. Really, thank you so much. Thank you so much. The first thing you will have already seen, and that's that we've launched a new series, and I think this is the opening scene of that film. So that's the first thing that I have to tell you. We have a new series running and it's looking at lost or invisible places. Something else that's going to be coming up over the next few weeks is that we're going to start using some of that plastic that you've been asking about. The first way that we're going to do that is we're going to show you some ideas how to use some plastics for Christmas decorations. Following that, we're going to show you how to make some Christmas decorations using glass and shells and other things that you can find as well. Last but not least,
thank you
so much.
Bye.
We'll see you next time.